D-Ball can still play.
Well, listen, this is your shot. This is your chance. This is your opportunity to redeem yourself. Everybody's waiting, and I know they're excited to see you back in uniform, as am I. Good luck out there today.
Thank you, man.
Man, I wish I had a jersey to put on.
If you want these scouts to buy in, you got to leave it all out there on the field. Come a long way. It's time to show off to the world. Let's go.
Yes, sir, coach.
Don't get in your head. Trust your arm, and you'll ace this.
All set?
Let's ride!
So, Charles, what are Devin and the guys facing on the first challenge?
Well, when we're calling a normal game, we call this four-minute offense. They call this first challenge put the game away. He's going to start at his 20-yard line with 4 minutes left on the clock.
All right, boys, here we go. All right, come on, eyes on me. Let's go out there and prove to the world that we belong.
Well, we definitely belong. I mean, I was all-conference at UT, and I know I haven't played it down in the NFL, but we're standing next to a bunch of dudes who have.
No, I know we do. All right, we just need to prove it to the scouts and to the people back home.
Oh, man, I can't wait till one of these dudes comes to me. I'm gonna show these guys just how fast a cruise missile really is.
All right, good. All right, look, these guys have never played together like we have. All right, we've been lining up in this huddle since we were 7 years old.
Yeah, it feels like old times, doesn't it?
Oh, you got that right, bro.
What's happening, fellas? Y'all got room for one more?
Yeah.
This is awesome.
One.
What are you doing here?
It's my audition tape, man. I went from playing with Philip Rivers to sitting on my couch. You ready to call it quits yet? Hey, I heard you know this long shot dude.
Oh, yeah, I played with this chump back in high school, man. You know that guy that has everything and still whines about it? That's him. I've had to work for everything in my life. I make some plays tonight, it might be my name to call next week instead of his. Yeah. Hey, you just stay out of my way, all right? Let's go.
Let's go, big boy. Come on.
All right, Devin, here's the play. Trips right, 34 blast. You got to drive down the field for 4 minutes without giving the ball back. Run out the clock and you complete the challenge. Give it back to the other team, you fail. Be careful, they're going to be expecting you to run, so I'm going to mix in plenty of pass plays.
That trips right, 34 blasts. Okay, ready?
Hey, long shot. You don't get hit today.
So here we go. First play, first challenge. Devin and his teammates need to hold on to the ball for 4 minutes.
And it's not going to be easy because you can't just run basic dive plays. They expect to take those 4 minutes off the clock. You still have to run your offense and take care of the flip clock.
So they pick up the first and extend the drive. What do you think? What do you expect from the defensive side?
Run blitzes and then run blitzes and then run blitzes because they've got to create a play here that makes things negative for the offense and puts them behind the chains, as we like to say, and forces their hand.
Buying time to his left. And he's got some space here. He's got room to run right off the bat. So that play gets him across midfield and in nice position.
Yeah, I'm impressed. I'm not sure where you stand on this one, but look, before we started, we really weren't sure what to expect. They've gotten past midfield now, starting to move the ball really, really well.
First and 10, Devin Wade drops back, escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. So, Charles, Devin Wade, everyone knows him through long shot. Maybe only the surface story. What is the backstory? Where'd he come from?
Well, let's go back to Mathis High School. When he came out, he was the number one quarterback in the country. Five-star recruit, and I would say that if they could give a six-star, he would have had it. Had all the tools. If he had been a baseball player, we would have said he was a five-tool kid.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Devin certainly has a little help back there. Justin Forsett lining up in the backfield.
When you think about all-purpose players, guys who can do it all, protect the passer, run the football, catch out of the backfield, as well as had a ton of patience in his NFL career, because it took him a long time before he became a starter, That's Justin Forsett, one of the fun ones.
Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Well, no problems moving the football on this opening drive. Now here's first and 10 from the 31. And now he'll tuck it and run. And now they are officially in the red zone.
Really good for them because I think Devin's done a really nice job so far. Look, he's got nerves, but he's harnessed them well.
In the red zone now, challenge number one, and the pressure mounting. First and 10, Devin Wade back to pass. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Big third down. Need to keep the drive alive and keep that clock moving.
And this is the challenge within the challenge for Devin Wade. You want to win the overall scenario, but at the same time, make plays that have the scouts write down their book. They like what they see.
Now this time he'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And it's a touchdown. I don't think that that's what the producers really expected when they put this challenge out there. That one puts the game out of reach.
Yeah, that technically counts as a win. Nice job.
A nice job by Devin Wade on the first challenge, don't you think?
Yeah, you know, he did just fine. He got rid of the nerves and showed that he could handle the pressure. But I do think it'll be interesting to see him handle what's coming up because there are a lot of challenges left.
Now, here's where guys under center make their money, the two-minute drill.
And that is challenging. But all-time greats like Dan Marino and Tom Brady, they've made their bones in moments like this. Let's see how Devin handles it.
All right. Here we go, fellas. Here we go. All right, let's go gun. Trips right, verticals. All right, let's get everybody deep. Let's get everybody deep.
Hey, there better be some looks for me on this drive here, Dev. I mean, we have been waiting for this our whole lives, man.
Yeah, don't worry. I got you, baby. Let's go.
Well, get me, too. I'm the one people remember. Oh, they're gonna remember the cruise missile. Trust me on that.
All right, here we go, y'all. Here we go. Ready? Right.
The who? Cruise missile?
All right, Devin, make smart decisions on this drive. Use the sideline. Conserve the clock. 80 yards to go.
First and 10. Watch that clock. Not much time. Devin drops back. Over the middle, complete. It's Cook. How about Team Longshot there, coming out with a little gusto, a big chunk on first down.
Yeah, obviously that is not what the defense wanted on that play. Aren't you glad we don't have Larry English mic'd up right now?
Probably a good thing for us, the FCC, and everyone involved. Back to something we were starting to talk about, Devin's history. You said he was a five-star quarterback when he went to Texas. What went wrong?
What's the word that we hear so often now with youngsters in today's society? Entitlement. All right, you know, when he first went there, he obviously looked the part. I think maybe Coach Hauser did him a disservice by handing him the job right after the spring game. Yeah, as I said, he definitely looked the part, but he wasn't ready. Not by a long shot, pun intended.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. On first down, Wade eluding the pressure right. That's caught. It's Thomas. They are right on the doorstep now.
They've covered a tremendous amount of ground since this challenge has begun. But guess what? They've got to finish it off in order to be successful.
And Devin Wade will throw it again. Flush to his right. So Devin calling his own number, and that's what he can do.
Yeah, might as well, right? He's the star of the show, and with his size and speed and running ability, carry the ball yourself and take it in just as he did.
Certainly a good job on passing the challenge, but maybe some little things that were a little off there.
I think you're right on target with that. Some good, some bad. And the good was that he handled all the big things very, very well. So there are some little things that you see that he needs to clean up, but that's true of every young quarterback, and I expect that to improve over time.
All right, now let's go to Dan Marino. He's been part of Devin's long shot team. Dan, I'm curious, were you part of the group that set up these challenges?
I was, and I look forward to this one the most. It will test every aspect of Devin's game. Devin will be backed up to the 1 yard line and has to drive the team into field goal range with very little time left on the clock.
And Dan, I like that these are so difficult. It'd be almost unfair to Devin if the show gave him a pass. Let's put him in these tough situations and see how he handles them.
Exactly what we're thinking, Charles.
I didn't think I'd ever be back here.
It's pretty cool, right?
Maybe for you, these people didn't exactly care for me too much when I left.
It's in the past.
Devin Wade, get off the field!
Or not.
Come on, everybody. Wade, you suck! Wade, you suck! Wade, you suck!
Okay, Devin, Wade, this is beyond difficult.
Wade, you suck!
I want you to focus on getting out of the end zone.
And then start working towards field goal range. Good luck.
All right, first and 10, first play of the drive, challenge 3, and they need to get this thing in field goal range quickly.
Backed up this deep, be careful. Team of legends, they may want to come after him with a blitz.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. They probably ran that play expecting just a couple of yards. They got much, much more than that. That's what they needed.
That almost felt like they were playing a game of Madden, didn't it? Caught the defense in the perfect setup. Had him overcommitting, and they hit him with the exact right play to break off that chunk of yardage.
Escaping the pressure right. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Cook. So with Wade, Charles, going back to his days at UT, you were saying he was handed the starting job right out of the gate?
Yeah, right away. And we're talking about a freshman with no experience. Now, you and I have seen this work before. But not in this case. They expect him to be the savior of the program. Unfortunately, he wasn't ready to handle it, and it was a mess.
Dancing to his left. He finds an opening past the 40, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. Throwing on first down, Wade. And he whips that one incomplete there. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas, and that'll bring up second down.
Set, green!
To throw again, Wade steps away to his left. Caught, it's Cruz, left side. Results in 6. Touchdown.
And I believe that Devin Wade thought to himself, let's not play for the field goal. Big time job by Devin Wade.
So passing the challenge, obviously a good thing. More positives than negatives to take away, I think you would certainly say.
I definitely do say that. More positives than negatives. Look, the foundation is there, all right? He's got to increase his overall confidence in his ability to play quarterback. He's got to do that part. We know that. But Jack Ford, he's kickstarted the process, and this is just the next step in the evolution of Devin Wade.
All right, look, this one's pretty simple, but there's something I want you to try on this challenge.
What?
I want you to prove to these scouts that you can play well without Colt. I want you to prove that you can do this on your own.
How? Are you going to take him out?
Nope. I just want you to complete the challenge without throwing a pass to him.
But why? What is that even going to prove?
Devin, you have relied on Colt your entire life, and it's time for you to show them that you can play well without him. Trust me. This is going to answer a lot of questions that these scouts have about you.
Okay, yeah, and I'll get the other guys more involved. No problem.
Hey, this is going to pay off, and I guarantee you it is going to mean something next week. Right?
You got it, Coach.
All right, here we go. All right, let's go single back, 324 rocket, X corner, Z drag.
Yo, what's the catch? It seems pretty easy.
I don't know. Jack didn't say anything to me, so.
Oh, Jack didn't say anything. What are you guys doing over there, exchanging recipes or something?
Look, man, hey, stop worrying about it. Let's just drive the ball down the field and score, all right? All right, here we go. Ready?
Time to see if Devin and Co. are ready to go for challenge number four, first and 10.
We know that the object is for Devin Wade to move his team downfield without relying on his best friend. How can he maneuver the team without just going back to him on each and every play?
Challenge number four beginning with an incomplete pass from Devin Wade.
So now he's got a chance to go ahead and take a deep breath, right? Kind of exhale a little bit, shake it off. Wasn't the result that he wanted, but at the same time, there's no disaster there. Still got a chance to move the ball downfield. Got to come back and make a play here.
Wade to throw. Being chased out left. And he's got room. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first. From midfield, here's Devin Wade. Buying time to his left. Now he'll throw deep left side. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Throwing again. Wade flushed out right. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. It is go time right now, and Team Longshot cutting it close.
To say the least, they obviously need a big play here. And in this situation, is there a chance for them to play a little basketball, go up top, and have someone go over the top of everyone else and make a big play? Let's see what they do.
Forced out to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. So the offense readies for a second and four. Now Devin from the shotgun. Going up top. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete.
Dude, this isn't just about you. You're not the only one trying to get drafted here. Throw me a bone.
Look, man, hey, I was just doing what I was told, man. That came straight from my headset. Hey, look.
Well, we knew the going was about to get tough.
Yes, sir. Devin and his crew ran to a buzzsaw on this challenge and have to be reeling a little bit.
Flying Oregon Ducks uniforms for this challenge, too? Come on.
I hope not.
D, just calm down, okay? You spent the last 6 months getting over that night, and I know you have. Now you just have to show millions of people at home that you have to.
You're right.
Let's go.
So here we go, challenge number five, and the raindrops starting to fall. This is a little eerie. I'm thinking, and I know you are, and I know most people are, this is becoming very reminiscent of that game against Oregon, his final game at UT.
You're exactly right. Now that it's starting to come down, that inclement weather is going to either get into his head or he gets out of his head, because that last pass he threw that actually counted, this exact situation, this exact scenario, he's got to defeat that in order to win this challenge.
One play here. Can Devin Wade finally put the demons to rest that have haunted him for the last 4 years?
Let's just get out of the half. Keep it simple. If it's not there, don't force it.
You got it, Coach.
Hey, yo, D, we need this. I can beat my guy deep.
Cold is not the play, man.
I know, but if we don't show something here, we might be sitting. Come on, you wanted to dedicate this game to your dad. Let's do it for him. Let's go. Out the open.
No matter what happens, I'm proud of you both.
You can't defend a perfect pass.
You know, well, there's no such thing as always a safe bet.
Throws to Forsett, who's going to be no way, and he gets free. Forsett with some room.
Hey, why aren't you smiling? You made the right decision. That checkdown's exactly what you're supposed to do on that play. Congratulations.
Hey, you know I would have caught that ball, right? No, you did the right thing. I'm proud of you, Dev.
Hey, what are you guys waiting for? Get out there. There's still time on the clock.
Okay, what are we gonna run?
Whatever you want. You earned it.
Hey, Coach, you got those launch codes?
Get out there.
For the cruise missile? Let's do it, baby.
Listen to
Come on, Dev.
Let's go.
Now the attention shifts to the offense with a minute 30 on the clock. Let's see if they play it safe or come out aggressive.
But this is a great opportunity for Wade to change history. If I'm him, I'm not playing it safe at all. I'm cutting it loose.
First and 10. Wade, he couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. To throw again. Wade. He's going to rifle one deep left side. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Devin will throw. Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down. In the red zone this time. On first down, Wade. And that'll be incomplete. All right, let's jump back to Devin's freshman year at Texas. You were saying a little bit of a mess.
Yeah, a little bit of a mess. He started out slow. They lost to Rice in their season opener. Did not play poorly, but at the same time, you're not supposed to lose to Rice. But then they had to go on the road in Provo and play BYU, and he threw a few interceptions. Again, the wheels hadn't totally come off yet, but at the same time, you're starting to see some signs.
Charles, if I'm hearing this correctly, and I think that I am, the Longhorn faithful in the crowd, they're now chanting Wade's name.
And for Devin Wade to come back to this stadium in front of these fans and win them over, you know it's something he's been dreaming about. What a special moment.
Was I all right? You were way better than all right.
You were so great.
Wasn't that awesome?
Stop, man. Julia, I got a little man in a suit named Ross Fontaine.
Fountain.
Fountain. He's trying to get backstage. Should I let him back?
Absolutely not.
Told you. Get your hands off me! Hey! Ah! Julia! I know you can hear me! I made you! Don't touch me! This is cashmere. What's wrong with you?
Devin, you better get changed. I'm sure some people would like to talk to you.
They put together a great show. I'm proud to be a part of it.
Would have been a lost cause without you.